History is full of criminal masterminds, people who use cunning and skill to outwit the law and commit infamous crimes. And then there is George Brittain Lyttle, known in the Old West as Dick Fellows, the notorious stagecoach robber who couldn't ride a horse. Born in Kentucky in 1845, Lyttle first experienced failure during the U.S. Civil War when he was captured by Union forces. Following the war and the death of his beloved mother, Lyttle turned to alcohol, and a short-lived attempt at hog farming in California didn't go so well either. But that's when Lyttle had an idea: to rob stagecoaches laden with cash and gold. Despite being a little unsteady on his rented horse, his first job was a success. But Lyttle was soon arrested by the authorities and sent down to San Quentin State Prison, where he served 4 years with time off for good behavior. Upon his release, Lyttle got right back to his old tricks, but one job didn't go so well. His first horse sent him flying, a second ran away, and a third had been fitted with one odd shoe. Authorities followed the unusual track straight to Little's hideout. But when Lyttle was arrested for a third time, he didn't go quietly. Having attacked his jailer, he jumped on a horse and attempted to make his escape, but the horse was stoned on loco weed and threw his assailant to the ground. It's rumored that after serving a final spell in jail, Lyttle returned home to Kentucky, his tail firmly between his legs. And that, sadly, is where his trail goes cold. Why do unlikely characters like George Brittain Lyttle become historical figures?